In this video, I will talk about the Newsvendor inventory model. In some previous videos, we talked about the EOQ model and the EPQ model, which both assume the demand is deterministic. In the Newsvendor model, however, the demand is stochastic. The Newsvendor problem can be described like this. A newspaper vendor must decide how many copies of the day's paper to stock in the morning. The demand is uncertain. Unsold copies due to overstocking will have little value at the end of the day. Unmet demand due to understocking will result in lost sales. What is the best quantity of newspapers that will minimize the expected cost? In other words, the newsvendor must order the number of papers that properly balances the overstocking and understocking costs. This type of models are called the Newsvendor models. It is also commonly seen in many other applications that have nothing to do with newspaper. The key characteristic of this type of problems is that they involve a penalty or cost for both overstocking and understocking because the demand is uncertain. Since the decision is made only once, the Newsvendor model is a single period decision model. Let CO be the unit overstocking cost for each unit unsold. CO is equal to the purchasing price plus the disposal cost minus the salvage value. Let CO be the unit understocking cost for each unit of shortage. CO is equal to the selling price minus the purchasing price, which is the profit we would have earned if the stock was available, plus the cost for the loss of goodwill. Let demand for the newspaper Y be a continuous random variable with the probability density function Fy. Its cumulative distribution function is capital Fy. Let X be the stock level, which is how many copies of newspaper the vendor should order. The goal of this problem is to find the optimal stock level X star that minimizes the expected total overstocking and understocking costs. The total overstocking cost is equal to the unit overstocking cost times the quantity. If the vendor overstocks the newspaper, the stock X is greater than the demand Y. So this part will be a positive value. Otherwise, there will be no overstocking cost. Similarly, the total understocking cost is equal to the unit understocking cost times the quantity. If the vendor understocks the newspaper, the stock X is less than the demand Y. So this part will be a positive value. Otherwise, there will be no understocking cost. Now let's take a deeper look at the objective function, the expected total cost. Because we assume the demand Y is a continuous random variable, and the demand cannot be a negative value, the expected value is equal to the integral of this total cost times f of y with respect to y over the domain of 0 to infinity. Let's divide the domain into two parts, from 0 to x and from x to infinity. If y is from 0 to x, we know x is always greater than or equal to y. So this item will be reduced to x minus y, and this item will be reduced to 0. If y is from x to infinity, we know x is always less than or equal to y. So this item will be reduced to 0, and this item will be reduced to y minus x. The unit overstocking cost and the unit understocking cost are constant, so we can move them outside the brackets. Then we can split this integral into two integrals like this. Similarly, we can also split this integral into two integrals like this. It turns out that this item is a cumulative distribution function for the demand of y that is less than or equal to x. This item is 1 minus the cumulative distribution function. It turns out this objective function is a convex function of the order quantity x. Let me show you why. we take the first order derivative with respect to x. This is what we get. Then we take the second order derivative with respect to x. The result is the unit overstocking cost, CO, times the probability density function, f of x, plus the unit understocking cost, CU, times the probability density function, f of x. Every item is greater than 0, so the second order derivative is greater than 0. Therefore, the objective function is a convex function. In order to solve for the optimal solution x star, we let the first order derivative equal to 0. X star is the optimal quantity that will minimize the expected total cost for the Newsvendor problem. The optimal order quantity can be determined by finding the value of X star that satisfies these two relations. This one means that the probability of the demand of Y being less than or equal to the stock X star is equal to this ratio, unit understocking cost, divided by the sum of unit overstocking cost and unit understocking cost. It is the overstocking probability. This one means that the probability of the demand Y being greater than or equal to the stock X star is equal to this ratio. It is the understocking probability. Now let's see an example. A newsstand owner is making a decision about how many copies of the next day's newspaper should be ordered. Each copy of newspaper costs $0.5 and is sold for $1. The unsold newspaper at the end of the day will be returned to the publisher for a refund of $0.25 per copy. Assume that the number of copies sold during the day follows a uniform distribution between 100 and 200. How many copies should the owner order? The purchasing price is $0.5 per day. The salvage value is $0.25 per copy. The selling price is $1 per copy. There is no disposal cost or goodwill cost. The unit overstocking cost, CO, is equal to the purchasing price plus the disposal cost minus the salvage value. It is equal to $0.25 per copy. The unit understocking cost, CU, is equal to the selling price minus the purchasing price plus the cost for the loss of goodwill. It is equal to $0.5. That means the overstocking penalty is half of the understocking penalty. Let's use this formula to calculate the overstocking probability. It is equal to 2 over 3. We use this formula to calculate the understocking probability. It is equal to 1 over 3. The probability of overstocking is twice as much as the probability of understocking. The reasoning behind this is that because the overstocking cost or penalty is less than the understocking cost or penalty, we need to determine the quantity X star so the vendor will have a larger probability of overstocking than understocking. The demand Y follows a uniform distribution. This figure shows the probability density function of a general uniform distribution with parameters A and B. The overstocking probability, or the probability of the demand Y being less than or equal to the optimal stock X star, is equal to the area represented by the shaded area. It is equal to X star minus A over B minus A. We can also show it in the cumulative distribution function. We also know that the overstocking probability is equal to 2 over 3, so we have this equation. Finally, the optimal quantity X star is equal to 166.7 copies of newspaper. In this example, we assume that the demand of the number of copies of the newspaper during the day follows a uniform distribution, U 100-200. What if the demand follows a normal distribution with a mean of 150 copies of newspaper and a standard deviation of 20? Now the demand Y follows the normal distribution, This figure shows the probability density function of a general normal distribution with mean mu and standard deviation sigma. The overstocking probability is equal to the area represented by the shaded area. We can convert it to a standard normal cumulative distribution, and it is equal to phi x star minus mu over sigma. Here is the cumulative distribution function. We also know that the overstocking probability is equal to 2 over 3. So we have this equation. Let's use the inverse standard normal cumulative distribution calculator to find the value of this item. The link to this online calculator is given below this video. In this box, type the probability value 0.6667, which is approximately 2 over 3. It shows the inverse is equal to 0.431. Finally, the optimal quantity x star is equal to 158.6 copies of newspaper. Okay, that is a Newsvendor inventory model. Thanks for watching.